Hi everyone, thanks for watching this video. It's going to talk about something on success formula for top 2%. When you look at the top achieving people in this world, I always surprise at them how some people are very successful in their career and in their personal life. Are they blessed by angel? Are they met the right people at the right time? So those are the questions keep coming. Because many times we try to do something which does not work. Could be in a relation, could be in your career. You want to do this, but it's not happening the way it is. Or we don't want to do certain mistakes, certain things which you don't want to commit it, but it happens. Maybe I thought I should not do that, but again, I'll do it. Again, I'll feel, shakes, man, I should not have done it. So this happens for many number of people, including me, right? So we have this problem, and it's not working. But how come this is working for some people? When you talk about some people, this set of category of people are either blessed by angel, you can take that way, or they have a good set of principles they follow. When you read the books of top achieving people in this world, in a career or a personal or any segment, could be sports, could be of a politics, could be of agriculture, could be of music, any industry in your domain to take, these are the people who do something very interesting. When I go through this content and I can see something interesting these people all have in common, and they make sure they follow this, and with this they get a consistent result starts happening. Probably we can go through this few points which can help you. Maybe slight movement, right, can change your life. As someone I read saying that if you want to achieve something you never achieved in your life, you have to be a person never been before. Some changes, right? So we'll start with that. In the sense, I will take up the point here. The first thing, what I can see with most of the achieving people is taking good care of their health. The first thing, you have to keep more focus on your health. In a sense, at least per day, 20 minutes you have to spend on yourself. And I say yourself, do some basic exercise, a stretch, a good walk, right? Good breathing habits. These are going to help you increase the oxygen level in your body, and that gives a fresh look and a fresh thought in your mind. Yeah, fit body can have a fit mind. Doesn't mean you have to become Brad Pitt or Salman Khan for a great exercise. It's just brisk walk, right? That makes a better thing. So health stands in the center of all your achievement in your life. So first thing is health focus. Perfectly good. That is 20 minutes per day. Once health things have been achieved or good happening, the second thing we have to focus, or the achieving people focus, is family life, the family around them. They spend good time with the family. When I say good time, you have to underline it. It's a quality time. So what do you mean by quality time? Whenever they talk to your spouse or elderly parents or their children, they have a good face-to-face communication. I have to stress it out, because most of the family nowadays with either mobile or a laptop or a television or something distraction, you don't give a full attention to them. If you really love somebody, you have to listen to them. That's the greatest gift you can give to somebody. So spending good time, at least in a day, 1 hour, you can spend time with your family, being in the kitchen for cooking, with your parents for some support, with your children for some activities, right? That makes a good connection. Family is a spinal cord for our whole process in our life. So health with a great family makes great achievers be great people. Now let's go to the third stage, the very important stage, that is learning. The learning process. Now what happened is, after academic, many take it for granted, I know things. Or I'm in the industry for 15 years, 20 years, 5 years, I know things. We know, but there is a difference between an ordinary and extraordinary. When you want to become extraordinary, you have to spend time learn on your domain. You go and take any top achievers in the world, they have a good reading habit on their subject. When you are here telling that, hey, I read Facebook, very good. I read LinkedIn, very good. I read politics, I read cinema, fine, good. Nothing wrong. But what is on your domain? How much of time you spend on the domain? Now, at least per day, you have to spend 20 minutes on your reading. Actually, it's a very less time, but still 20 minutes is a good start. Now, the book stat says that if you are reading about your domain 20 minutes every day, within 5 years of time, you will be the top in your domain. Woo! That's a good thing, right? So learning makes a better person. Now, we saw certain interesting factors, right? Now, let's see the main factor why we put all these efforts. Now, the effort is creating wealth. So that's going to be the top skill. Now, the wealth can be of earning money or earning great value. Not everybody thinks wealth means money. It could be a good value in the society, isn't it? Helping people around. And also, money comes into factor. We need money, isn't it? To show the sign of prosperity. Now, the point here is money does not come directly. So when you have a good health, when you have a good family behind you, when you have a good learning habits consistently, wealth starts happening. And again, the misconception, when you have all this stuff, wealth automatically comes. No, you should create value. If somebody spends 1 hour, their value is different. The same work done by another person for 3 hours, the value is different. The time value differs, isn't it? Right? Michael Jackson being on the stage for half an hour, the rate is different. Some other person dancing on the floor doesn't make a big deal, right? The point is, how do you create value for your each minute? How do you create it? How do you express your thoughts? That's important. What you know is not a big deal. How do you utilize a knowledge? How do you convey it? How do you spread it? How do you materialize it? That's pretty important. So you should know how to market yourself. You should know how to bring out the knowledge to the market. That's pretty important. That goes back to the wealth generating factor. Now, one of the points I put here is a quick recall. You want to give a good focus on the health habits, good food habits, good sleeping habits, good exercise. Very, very important to be a good leader at the top 2%. And you have a good family background where you spend time with the family. Everything starts from us. We can't expect somebody else to do for our family, right? We have to do that. That's for the family. And then comes a learning part. It's a very important. Without learning, nothing moves forward. That's very important. And then goes for the wealth factor. The earning starts happening. Now, this is some of the good things which I can go through. Good achievers in the market who call them as a top CEOs or a great saint, or would be a good mom or a good dad, right? So it doesn't mean always money factor. But these factors, what we discuss here, could be a life changing. Sure, will it happen overnight? I would say no. It will take some time. You have to consciously focus on this area every day. I sometimes call it as focus one day at a time. Don't too much stretch yourself, right? When you wake up, these are things I'm going to do. 20 minutes for my health, 20 minutes for my family. 20 is pretty less, but still 20 minutes with the family, talk to them, spend time with them, smile with them, look at the face, don't look at the devices around, right? And read every day 20 minutes and automatically start marketing yourself and you know you're growing high, right? Thanks for watching this video and we'll talk about how leadership happens, how top 2% succeed in the world. Reach out to us for any questions and queries. We'll be so happy to help you. Keep rocking as top 2%. Good wishes.